in Montreal, you performed quite a lot of French music and made some, well, they become gramophone classics now, those recordings you made with the orchestra and some French repertoire. Obviously, having studied with Charles Munch in Tanglewood, you have a special understanding of that music. Is that something you'd like to explore with the orchestra? What do you think makes, what is the secret of unlocking French music?
Oh, this is very difficult. very rarely is this repertoire played very well, you see, because it does not work with the international style. You see, you can play a lot of music, you know, like, you know, today we play a lot of Mahler, Shostakovich, and this. But, you know, if you play Debussy, Ravel, and even Berlioz, you know, it's rarely played well. It requires a lot of work, special technique, sound, special way of moving the bow, special vibrato, the elegance of the sound. So, It needs a lot of work. Now, for me, Montreal, it was easy. It was not actually my intention to do that. It was actually Decca Records came, and you know, because I grew up in Geneva around Ernest Anselmi, who was, you know, for 35 years a very big name in the industry, and had recorded many things for the first time, first on 78, then on 33, then stereo, then quadraphonic, and everything, except CDs, of course, because this came later. So the question was, why don't we re-record this repertoire with this new technology that was in the early 80s? And it was very interesting, you see, because the CD was just born, and the technology, the sound, you know, technology also. So that's why we went this way. You see, that way. And the first recordings had a great success because it was a new way of listening to this music. You know, everything was much more, was clearer and so on, and the colors would come out and so on. So we were encouraged to go ahead, you know, to see, you see. But we have done many, many records, about 100, you know, so we have recorded a lot of things. Berlioz is also a case, because Berlioz is played like a late romantic composer, most of the time with a big sound, you know, so, which is wrong, because it's a very classical sound, you know. Berlioz is actually basically Beethoven, plus some instruments, you know, that came from the theater, basically, you know, like these tuban, like this piccolo clarinets that came from military band or the orchestras, opera orchestras at the time. So, you know, when even the symphony fantastic is so rarely well played, because it's, you know, always a big thing. There's a fever, but the sound should always be a classical.
You see? So that there's something that you could transform with this orchestra then.
We could do that, but you know, you have a great great personality, conductor Colin Davis does that so well here, I mean, I always admired his work, and so you already know about that, you see, but that would be a good idea to do that, and I intend to do that, but we should have played more, because we cannot play only the symphony fantastique, you see, we should do all of it. There's not so much, actually, symphonic repertoire. There are only a few overtures, three symphonies, and the rest is vocal, you know, the Damnation of Faust, the L'Enfance du Christ, Te Deum. So, of course, I do that all the time. And we have actually, we're in the middle of a cycle in Philadelphia, because Philadelphia has never been a Berlioz city, and you know, they don't really know. I mean, the orchestra do. But the public, no, we just played the Te Deum. It was the first time probably that it was played in the city. And so that would be great. But for that, I need to have a cycle, you know, of concerts in the hall.
Develop the technique and the sound. And yeah, presumably you will do a lot of Russian repertoire with the orchestra and German repertoire. And they all have their own particular technique and style, don't they? I mean, they're all very different in the way they need to be played. So these are things
I think every composer, every style has its sound.
Yes.
And what I'm trying to find is a general sort of way of playing which is honest. It's not that you're hiding things by playing loud or big, having this big, fat sound which hides a lot of things. No, I would say that my tendency coming from chamber music is to make the public aware of what's in it. And you may hear things that you have never heard before, you see, to balance the orchestra properly. This is one general approach, but in every direction you have a different sound and you have to respect the style. I mean, you don't play Berlioz like Brahms or vice versa, you see? That is my concern, is to find, with a general approach, to just respect the sound as much as I can, of course, the sound and the style of each composer, the combination. But also this, you know, there's an important factor. All the great orchestras in the world have basically been built by a conductor or two in a special venue, you know. That's why I don't understand so much here in London, because it goes all over the place, less than before. But, you know, if you see the Concertgebouw, if you say Philadelphia, if you look at Chicago, if you look at Berlin, if you look at, St. Petersburg, it's always a hall and a conductor and a school which came out of that. Depending on the personality of the conductor and the kind of repertoire that they were repeating more often, you see. And obviously, these orchestras at the time had very strong differences in terms of sounds. Philadelphia and Chicago and Boston were three different schools, you see. And it was coming from Stokowski or Mendy one day, but from Münch Kusevitsky, which is a bit more my school, in fact, you know, Russian-French, it's close, you know, school, and and so on. And Cleveland, for instance, had this special classical sound of George Zell, and Concertgebouw was the combination of Mengelberg at the beginning, but also the hall, which is so rich, and, you know, I mean, the orchestra, the Concertgebouw is a beautiful sound. If they had they been educated or rehearsing, in a different venue, they would have a different sound as well.
Yeah, people don't realize how important these factors are.
Oh, yes, it is, absolutely.
No two orchestras sound alike.